Hey guys, Pasty Boy here. Today I'm going to replace this gate behind me with a larger gate so I can get my riding mower in and out without having to remove the post that's there now. Okay, we'll give it a little tug here, but we're going to get this wire tight with the turnbuckle at the other end. So right now, let's put this near the end and snug these up. All right, now once I tighten the other end, I will cut the excess off. All right, so you got to tighten this up like this, which will tighten it into here, but unscrew it from here. You don't need to crank it too much, but I'll do a bit just to get this nice and taut. All right, directions just say to tighten. It's seems plenty tight to me, and so now it's time to lay the chain link fence on it. But before I do that, I'm going to trim the excess cable off. All right, so I'm going to use a pair of lineman's pliers to cut this extra cable off. I'm going to leave just a little extra just in case you ever need to do any more adjustments or whatever. All right, so I stretched out the chain fabric here and I put the rod through. You gotta weave it in and out through one end and then put these clamps on just like that. And then we'll start stretching it to the other side. Make sure that all of these links are even all the way down. You might have to do a little messing around because they might be out of place. So check them, make sure they're all linked at the top and bottom and everything before you start attaching it to the other end. That one needed to be turned over, but make sure that they're still looped together. And then you can see I have a couple here at the end, but these are going to get removed, so I'm going to just unwind them. And you're going to notice that some of the loops here will want to get caught on stuff, so maybe pinch those over so they can't hook anything. And we'll throw it aside. So it looks like I got to remove up to this one here. So I'm going to unloop this and just take this one out. So once you get this one out, you'll have all the ones you need removed. All right, I think I got it all even at each end. I'm gonna fish the rod through. And then I'll have to pull it and put the other clamps on. I'm gonna start up at the top here, the clamps, and see if I can get them on. And we'll put one in the middle. The only thing is I gotta hone this down, then in the chain link needs to be more even. And we gotta get it through this link too. There. I put one of those up at the top and looped it around. And now I'm gonna do one at the opposite corner to try to get this even. For some reason, I don't know if it almost seems like the gate is lopsided, but it shouldn't be. So they give you 10 of those, so it's 5 for the top and 5 for the bottom. I'm gonna put the rest of those on, make it even. All right, I've got them all on. So that's the top hinge side over there. So it's gonna go straight up and attach over there. Yeah, looks pretty good. And so next, I believe, is to put the hinges on here. So I'm gonna measure what I have over there. That way they'll match. All right, so I'm gonna mount this hinge clamp about approximately 12 inches up from the bottom. Can be adjusted after, but I'll put that one on first. All right, I've got the two hinges on roughly. It's the top, it's the bottom. I'm gonna pick it up, hook it on, and then adjust the top one. And then we'll be ready for the latch and be done. So I got to do some adjusting to the hinges so that it hangs correctly at the other end of the post. All right, so there looks like fairly even, but it looks like there's a little out of square here for some reason. May have tightened this too much, but, and I'm gonna put the latch on. All right, let's put the latch on. Got all these pieces and the two bolts. You can adjust this at any height that you like, I suppose, but I don't think you want it too tight. No, I'm just getting that on there temporarily so it doesn't fall down. Actually, I'm going to spin this around because I want the smooth side facing out. All right, now that I have both nuts on there, and bolts, I'm gonna loosen this off until it's about halfway. So I want this to be spaced out evenly. Okay, I'm gonna start with the wrench on this side. I want this pretty even too, you don't want it cocked. Okay, so we'll take this back off. So I have to put the latch in there. Almost forgot that. Not gonna do much if you don't have that in there. Okay, so it'll go like this. Now obviously this side can't be as tight because this has to be able to move. We'll get about here. And then we'll just go ahead and tighten this bolt. And we'll give this one just a little. Now, in the bottom here, the little slot with a hole, if you want to put a lock on it. Not necessary, but it's an option. So let's see how she closes. Right, she's definitely a little cattywampus there. I'm gonna have to figure out why it's not a little straighter. It must be when I pulled that too tight there. I'm gonna loosen that up and see if that helps. All right, so I loosened up that turnbuckle there at the top. I guess I had it a bit too tight. It's more level now, more square. Obviously the ground, and this is a long gate now, and the ground isn't completely flat, so when I open it out that way, about halfway open, I'll show you here, it starts to come in contact with the ground. The other gate did too, but since it was shorter, it could open more. But when I go in, you know, it's going up. So we've got more space, and we can go all the way to here, and that's plenty to get in and out with the rider. So I'm gonna call this a success. That chain link, as you are unraveling it, it can be a little tricky. It can get hung up on itself, and I did have a little trouble. I didn't film it, but I had to, you know, get it untangled. So don't get discouraged if you find yourself a little frustrated because the chain link fence part is, you know, tangled up a little bit. Just figure out where it's hung up and unhook it a little bit. And then you'll also have to calculate how tight you want this. I wanted this really tight, just, you know, it's actually tighter than that fence there, but that may be because it's old, I don't know, starting to wear, or they just didn't put it on as tight, but I wanted this nice and taut. So it's on there good. It's gonna do the trick. I don't have to pull a post out of the ground anymore. And that other gate over there, I will probably either next summer use as a garden fence gate, or maybe put a fence on the other side of my house next spring. So I won't need much hardware. I got a post and the gate, and I'll just need these parts here that didn't come with this one in the box. So that's just a heads up, you'll need these parts if you are attaching it to an existing fence that doesn't have these on them already. If you're not removing a gate, you're going to need to buy those. And these are the male ends. Comes with the female ends. All right. Get a shot from the other side. All right, there she is, all done. So it looks like the final opening is 66 3/4, roughly, because that post is a little out of square. But it's obviously on that post square. And it opens decently. It's fairly square as far as the gate goes. And that's about it. Let's open her up. Awesome. If in the future I wanted to turn this into a double gate, I could always put that gate over there on this end and then, you know, change the landscape here a little bit. But I think this is gonna do just fine. All right, so a little advice I'd give is maybe get a helper. This will definitely aid when putting the thing together. It's a little harder by yourself. It can be done, obviously I just did it, but it would have been helpful to have someone else there. Maybe a pair of gloves, because that chain link is really sticky and everything. What else? Maybe a picnic table to set it up on. You saw I had four horses, but it would have been a lot better if I had a true flat surface to set it up on that can, you know, hold the whole gate. But like you saw, you know, it can be done either way. So if this helped you at all, please give the video a thumbs up. Check the links in the description. Check out the suggested videos here at the end of this video. And I thank you for watching. Take care.